Dr. Jason Saunders here with HBOT USA and another research review. Today we are going to talk about hyperbaric oxygen as it relates to Lyme disease. We are doing this video from Hyperbarics International. That is Dick Rutkowski's place where he spends time training doctors and paramedics and EMTs and nurses, physician's assistants, all on hyperbaric oxygen and training on the usage and protocols for hyperbaric oxygen. So today we're going to talk about HBOT and Lyme disease. And so Lyme is obviously an infection. It's a arthropod, it's a spirochete, and it's anaerobic infection. And the infection is typically caused by Borrelia burgdorferi, although there are some other Borrelia species out there. There has not been a tremendous amount of research done on hyperbaric oxygen as it relates to Lyme. Even that being true, I would say it's one of the top three things we end up seeing in our office clinically. And the results that we get in our office using hyperbaric oxygen for Lyme are typically very significant for these patients. So here was a particular study that was done. What they were doing is they were trying to figure out at what pressures are patients responding to improved symptoms, as well as at what pressures might kill the actual infection itself. And so what they found was it took a pressure of about 2.36 to kill the actual infection. However, lower pressures were able to be used for clearing of symptoms, especially neurologic symptoms and inflammatory symptoms. And so these patients were treated at 100% oxygen, 60 minutes a day, for 5 days in a row, took 2 days off, 5 days in a row, and they did that for about 30 treatments. Of the group, there were a total of 20 treatments per patient, a total of about 2,000 sessions of hyperbaric oxygen in total. And the response rate was about 84.8% had massive improvements in their symptoms. So that's just one particular study. But like I said, this is one area that there is not a lot of research yet, though I'm sure that it's coming in the near future. However, clinically, not just in my office, but in other offices that we talk with, we see a tremendous amount of improvement in all the neurologic findings, in the pain issues, in response to hyperbaric oxygen. And the pressure ranges and the oxygen ranges really just depend on the state of the person. Is this an acute infection? Is this a chronic infection? So those are things that will help dictate whether the treatment is a long-term treatment, a high-pressure treatment, a high-oxygen treatment, etc. So hope that helps. Thanks a lot.
Hi, Jay.